Good afternoon. I welcome you to the afternoon session of, and in this session we'll have a demo of Snort. So Snort is basically a network sniffer, logger and intrusion detection system. Its logger and sniffer function are similar to that of Wireshark, so we will only be focusing on intrusion detection part of Snort. As an intrusion detection system, Snort captures packets from the network and matches them against some conditions defined by us and generates an alert if the conditions are met. These conditions we define in Snort rules, which we will see in a while. This is a setup in which Snort has to be installed in a network. You can see there is a router which is connected to internet, and there is a firewall which is connected to the internal network, and there is a switch in the middle which has a mirrored port on which Snort has to be connected. This setup is such that all the traffic that is passing through the switch can be monitored by the Snort. We have given you a text file which says how to run Snort. It has the commands to run Snort and also Barnyard. Barnyard is a backend tool which is used to transfer the alerts generated from logs to databases so that we can easily view them. The first command we have, it runs Barnyard. You have to run this in a terminal and keep that terminal open. The next command is for running Snort. When you run Snort, there is an option of Ethernet interface. Here in the given command, the Ethernet interface is ETH0. You have to check on your own system what is the interface there. Type ifconfig in your terminal and find out what is the interface and replace that interface with ETH0. I'm sorry, replace ETH0 with that interface in the command. And also we'll have a Snort interface which is running on the local host. You can view it using this address that is given in the bottom on that file, how to run Snort. So coming back to the demo, first we will see how do we detect port scan using Snort. As sir has already told, port scan is a process by which an attacker tries to figure out what services are running on the victim server, which ports are open, which OS is running. For detecting port scan using Snort, we don't have to write any specific rules because Snort has already provided a preprocessor which does all the detection. We only have to switch on that preprocessor. For doing that, we will have to edit a file snort.conf. It is located in the location /user/local/snort/etc. As you can see, there is a file snort.conf in that location. We open that file and search for port scan. As you will see, there is a line which is commented out that says preprocessor SF port scan. So this is the directive which enables port detection of port scanning. We uncomment that line and we save this file. Here we see that there is an option of log file. There we can change where we want the logs to be generated. Here it is given var/log/snort. The log file will be generated there. We save this file and then we have to restart Snort. We copy this command and run it on a terminal. Here we have replaced ETH0 to ETH5 because that was the interface in my system. Now Snort has started running. Now we will do a port scan on our system from some other system. That other system is a host which is running our virtual machine. This is the IP of virtual machine. We will go to Windows, that is the host, and in nmap tool we will give the IP of virtual system and press enter. Now nmap will take some time to finish. Now the results of port scan have come. You can see the scanned IP was this, and it shows that host is up. It is showing 999 ports are closed and one port is open, that is TCP on HTTP. And it also shows the OS, that is Ubuntu. Now as port scan has been done, Snort must have detected that someone had tried to figure out what ports are open here. I mean, try to figure out the port scan. So let's go to the log and check there. Log was present in the directory var/log. There is a directory called snort there. As we can see, a file has been created. We open that file. In that file, we can see that the first log is of TCP port scan. It was done on this time. And the attacker's IP was 160.242, and victim, that is our virtual machine, its IP was 160.247. The next log is for UDP port sweep and then for UDP port scan. Next we are going to see how we write rules. As I have already said, rules are the conditions against which the packets are matched. Rules are located in the location /local/snot/rules. When you list this directory, you can see that there are already so many files present. These files are the rule files that have been downloaded from snot rules website. You can search on Google and go to snot rules website and download these rules. However, you can also write our own custom rules that I am going to show. For writing our local rules, we have to open file local.rules. For this demo, I have already written some rules, but all are commented out. I will uncomment the simplest rule of all. A rule has two parts, header and options. The highlighted part is header. Header tells snot which packets it has to look into. The first field in a header is action. Here we can see the action is alert. This means snot will generate an alert and log that packet. Apart from alert, the other options that we can give are log, that won't generate an alert, it will only log the packet, and pass, that will simply ignore the packet. The next field is protocol. Here the protocol is TCP. That means that this rule is applicable only on TCP packets. The next fields are destination. Next fields are IP and port of source, and then IP and port of destination. These are the sources and destinations of packets that have to be seen. And here any is a wildcard which will match against any IP and any port. For the destination IP, we have given the IP of our virtual machine. So that was the header part. The other part is options. The first option we have is message. It says what that rule does. And next option is SID. It is a unique identifier of the rule. Then we have rev, that stands for revision. The revision of this rule is 1. So what this rule will do is, whenever it receives any TCP packet which is coming from any source on with any port to our machine, it will generate an alert. It is basically a dummy rule. Similarly, we will have another rule which will generate an alert for UDP packets. After this, we save the file and exit. Now we will have to restart snot. When snot has started, we will go to our browser and open some random web pages to create connections. After that is done, we kill snot and this is the tab which is running Barnyard. It shows that these were the alerts generated which have been read from the log and transferred to database. The Barnyard does these things. Now we will go to the interface, web interface of snot. We copy this address and paste it on our browser. In that interface, we can see that two types of alerts were generated for the two rules that we uncommented from a local.rules file. The first alert is alert shows UDP detected. We can click on the summary and see the alerts in detail. As you can see, the source IP of those packets are shown here along with the FQDN. It is fully qualified domain name. Similarly for TCP also, we can see the summary. There were so many TCP connections. So now we are moving to a content keyword which is an option we can give in the rules. We will again open the local.rules file. We comment the previous rules and uncomment the new rule that we are going to see. The header part of this rule is almost the same except the options part. In options, we have added a new keyword content which has a value some site. This will tell snot that it has to generate an alert whenever a packet comes which contains this string in its payload, this string some site. Apart from giving a simple string, we can have hex values instead. The hex values are enclosed within pipes. As you can see, this is also a valid rule that we can give. it will search for the string some site and hex value 000e2f and 01. For keeping things simple, we will keep string only, and then we close the file and we have to restart snort. Remember that every time we change a rule, we have to restart snort, and also if we change something in snort.conf file, we have to restart. Once snort has started, we go to our browser and open somesite.com. It is some random site. This ensures that there must be a TCP packet which has the string somesite in its payload. Now let's go to snort interface again and refresh the page. It shows that a new alert has come which says unauthorized keyword detected. If we see the summary, we see that that packet was coming from this IP which is listed under source IP, and destination IP is the IP of our machine. Now the next rule we are going to see, it is for detecting SYN flood. As sir has told already, SYN flood is an attack when an attacker tries to open a large number of TCP connections on a victim server so as to use all the resources of the server. Let's see the rule for that, for detection. We'll comment the previous rule and uncomment this. Here also the header part of the rule is almost the same. The changes we have done is in the options part. In options, the first is message which says SYN flood detected, and the other options are flag S. This means that snort will check for the TCP packets which have SYN flag set. The other options are detection filter, track by source, count 20, seconds 20, and the rest options are same, SID and revision. So what this means is, using this rule, snort will generate an alert whenever it sees 20 or more TCP SYN packets that are coming from a single source within 20 seconds. So that will basically indicate a SYN flood attack. We will again close this file, save and close. And then we restart snort. Now we create a situation which simulates a SYN flood attack. We have written a small Java program which sends a large number of TCP requests, TCP SYN requests. We will run it from our host system targeted at our virtual machine. The attack is done. Now we will see the logs in the interface. When we refresh this page, we can again see that a new alert has come which says SYN flood detected. The number of alerts is 20, and when we click on the summary, we can see from which IP that attack was done. The source IP tells that, and destination IP is our IP. So that was all for the demo.